Good morning, friends. Everybody knows water is life. And a lot of experts have told next world war will be for water. Any country which has more water, they are going to survive. Now let us look at the history. From almost 220 BC, Chinese have built more dams than anybody. They have more than 50,000 dams. Dam means you collect water in a catchment area, create a reservoir, store it, and distribute very nicely for agriculture, for drinking, for human use. All towns and cities have developed close to the rivers. Whole civilizations are still named after rivers, like a Sindh civilization. We all know the importance of water, but water is decreasing. You cannot create water. What happens? How do we get water? Through the rain. We get water for 40 to 60 days. That is the only source of water. That water has to recharge our lakes, recharge our rivers, recharge our land, and we need to reuse them. We are losing almost close to 90% of water going waste. That means water coming from rain, we are not able to store and just goes. Every year rivers are flooded and the whole water goes to the oceans. Whereas, look at the developed countries, Western European, especially China. Actually, they developed because of water conservation. Almost 85% of their rainwater is being utilized by the country. Only they lose about 15% of water through rivers and drainage and other systems. But we have a lot of rivers, we have a lot of rainwater, all that water. Nobody ever thought all these years. We just want to make dams and lakes, keep on spending crores and crores and rupees. One TMC of water, you need to spend 400 crores. Starting from Jawaharlal Nehru's time, we have made those five big dams those days. And after many years, we have only 5,000 dams. Out of them, not even 500 of them are big dams. Where 50,000? Where 5,000? And only 500 are useful dams. And out of them, only handful of dams which are on the major rivers, which at least store some water. Ultimately, we leave them. Our government of India, Sri Narendra Modi ji also, their vision is 5 trillion economy. 5 trillion economy. How are we going to achieve? Through agriculture development, through proper water management, the proper process of this economy. Let us look at the problems. We are losing water. We are not storing water properly. Or we are not replenishing our old dams and rivers and lakes and water bodies in the country. There are a couple of IAS officers, I don't remember their names, who made a lot of check dams in Maharashtra and eradicated water problems in some villages. And we all know water flows. It flows. It doesn't stay unless you create a storage. Now let me remind you one story. Colonel Suresh Patil, retired from army. We are all part of Green Thumb. Green Thumb was created in early 1990s in Pune. That time I was also in army. And my unit was 14 grenadiers, where in that year alone, we have planted 1 lakh trees and created a rain water bodies. And I really salute Colonel Patil and his team and a lot of grinders. I mean, we call them grinders, grenadier officers and men. Those units, I don't remember all of the names. With our teams, we have created a green revolution in Pune city. And Colonel Patil and our team have converted many nallas, dirty canals, into a green revolution today. There, people are visiting there. People can sit in front of those dirty canals once upon a time. They are flourishing now. One man's vision, a teamwork, and a proper direction. Almost 2010, Kalpatil has started alone. Then a lot of team members have joined. I must really appreciate him. Sir, salute you. You have taken away project in Khadakwasla Dam. A proud grinder, 14 Grenadier officer, you have done wonder. I'll tell you a small story. Remember, to create one TMC of water is impossible. Khadakwasla Dam was made in 137-140 years old. That time Pune city was very, very small, couple of thousand people were there. Today the people have expanded to lakhs of population. And that is the only dam for drinking water purpose in the whole Pune city and the surrounding villages. Every 40 to 50 years, the silting will reduce almost one TMC of water. This Khadakwasla Dam reservoir once upon a time made for 1.37 TMC of water storage. It is reduced to 1.9 TMC of water in 137 years. No governments, leaders, local population ever visualize the damage is happening. Same thing happened in Hyderabad. When I came to Hyderabad in 1970, the Usman Sagar, such a big lake. Himayat Sagar was very, very big. And Shamirpet Lake was wonderfully large. Now all these lakes are almost small, they have become small. Houses have encroached them. So all over the world the story, yes, urbanization is going to definitely take these catchment areas. Coming back to Khadakwasla Lake, so Kalpatil, with the help of army, with the help of local people, NCC, NSS, and all of us behind him. So the green thumb has taken up desilting of the Khadakwasla Dam reservoir. Nobody thought, when he presented to people, scientists, they never realized. 30, 40 meters, he has just slowly started. He took bulldozers from army, especially BEG center then in Bomb Engineering Center in Pune. The officers were fantastic. Army officer always, military officers are really great. Lots of ex-service officers, ex-service men came forward. And the project started in 2010. Next, just matter of 4, 5, 6 years now, the dam has increased almost 0.2 TMCs of water increase in the reservoir. And people realize it is focused. Kalpatil was invited to give his presentation in Sweden. He was invited in Philadelphia. He was given some couple of awards, but he is never worried about it. He is such a war veteran and retired soldier. All of us, in a matter of fact, we are all retired soldiers and we have devotion towards the country and well-being of the country. We never look for our real estate income or what is it we are going to accumulate for next generations. That's how army has taught us. Looking at the situation, Khadakwasla project in about 6 years time increased 0.2 TMC of water. Now look at the other side benefits of this desilting. 25 lakh lorries of tons of the silt which is taken out, we call it brown gold because it is like a urea. They have distributed to all the villagers. It has almost reduced their urea utilization by many tons of urea. That means it has reduced couple of crores of money of Indian government. Your urea subsidy can be reduced couple of thousand crores. Brown gold, which can save your blue gold, that is your cash. And catchment area treatment and water storage has increased. Fish started growing. Fisheries has increased and the drinking water supply has increased. You have saved the Pune city from couple of years from drinking water shortage. Can you imagine? Small vision. Government has really appreciated his work. Green thumbs, effort. Now the next benefits are the greenery around catchment area treatment. That means plantation of grasses, bamboos, trees. It attracted people. People started making picnic. And a lot of industries have come to give their money Because now nowadays you all know the rules. They have to spend some money for social service. So all the companies have started promoting our project, and Khadakwasla Dam project is the only project in the world that desilting can result in storage. It has all costed, if you multiply every paisa, it costed 4 crores. We saved our taxpayers' money. This is a model which has been appreciated, published very widely all over the country in the media. Now India has 5,000 dams. There are lakhs of ex-servicemen who are healthy, who are ready to work. There are a lot of youth. I won't tell the government now. Now if you open a big industry like a BHEL, you can employ 20,000 people. Very good. But computerization, automation, what will happen? All these 25,000 will become only 1,000 employees. So you're going to have 24,000 employees. That's why all these governments giving youth salaries, unemployment salaries, wastage of money. Government should use this youth for environmental cleaning, to help the police, or desilting of dams. Why not our state governments use their brains, use their ideology, and provide occupation? Let him work with the dam. You give him 10,000 rupees. Let the teams help experts like us who can do your desilting of the dams. Making a new dam is going to cost you 5,000 crores. Minimum expenditure for a small dam is also 1,000 crores today. But desilting can happen in only 2 crores, 3 crores, 4 crores. And it can save your urea. It can give brown gold to a farmer, enrich his lands. It can improve your fisheries. Catchment area treatment will result to catchment area plantation. It will develop a arboriculture. It will develop a new social forestry. It will invite your animal kingdom to expand. You're developing a biodiversity. Water is not just water for humans. This water is responsible for the existence of this planet. The whole climate change is going to turn to your convenience. It is not just a desilting of dam. It is in a philosophy and ideology to save this Mother Earth. So my dear friends, I have shared one small model of Khadakwasla Dam. There are people like us who are ex-servicemen. There are retired police. There are youth. All of us are the brigade for government to work for these things. Do you think the next generation is going to save this Mother Earth? They can if they have a guidance. We need to train them. Please, government, please revise their syllabus. I shared a philosophy of desilting of a single dam, Khadakwasla. And this is the model which is going to change the country. Prime Minister sir, and different CMs of different states, you please give us the opportunity, because still we have energy. Green thumb. Not only one green thumb, we need a green hand to come together and change this world. I am telling you, there is a solution, but it will be too late. We will be left with no solution.